And there'll be more from the Rugrats tomorrow morning here on Holiday Hop.
Now, we want to know what the worst present you've ever received. What's the worst present you've ever got?
It's got to be a leather passport holder.
What?
Can you imagine when you go on holiday, it's in a nice leather patch?
Oh, here's my passport. Nasty. The worst thing I ever got was a monkeys video.
What, a video of monkeys?
No, 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 listen. The monkeys were a pop band from the 60s. My aunt got me, I knew it was a video, right, because I could feel it was wrapped up, and right. I was very excited. It was a monkeys video of a 60s pop band that I'd never heard of.
That is disappointing, I have to
What's
say.
The worst present you have ever received? Email us cbbc@bbc.co.uk.
Or you can fax us on 020 88 11 10 11. We'll read it as many as we can throughout the week, so get plenty of them in. Now it's time to play Santa's Christmas Cracker, and there's two callers on the line.
The first one is Vaz. Good morning, Vaz.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Fine.
Are you looking forward to Christmas?
Pardon?
Are you looking forward to Christmas?
Yeah.
So am I, can't wait. All right.
Okay, your opponent's date is Sean. Morning, Sean.
Hi, Michael.
Hey, how are you doing this morning, mate?
Okay.
Are you ready to play the game?
Yeah.
Okay, well, fingers crossed for you both, because it's now time to play Santa's Crazy Christmas Cracker.
Vaz, you were through first on the line, all right? I'm going to show you your very first prop, right? This is the first one. Don't mention it until you've seen Michael with your second one. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Your time starts now.
Santa. Star. Present. Christmas pudding. Balls. Bell. Tinsel. Hat. Dog.
Yeah! We've done it! We were there, we were a little bit slow, but I think we just about did it. Well done to you, Vaz. Congratulations, you are going to win yourself a fantastic section of prizes. We've got some watches, games, and some CBBC goodies for you as well. Okay, so it's on to Sean now.
Sean.
Sean, do you reckon you could do just as well?
Probably.
Probably. Good luck, okay. Sean. All right, are you ready to play?
Yeah.
All right, remember, this is the very first prop. Don't mention it until you've seen Michael's second. Good luck. Good luck. Go.
Santa Claus. A racket.
Oh, it's tricky. No, the computer has used a slightly too long a pause there. Slightly too long a pause. I'm sorry about that. It's very harsh, but we will send you some CBBC prizes. Sean, are you all right?
Yeah.
Thanks, mate. Sorry about that. It was tricky, wasn't it? Follow me over here. It was a bit tricky today, wasn't it?
It is, but thanks for playing anyway. And have a Merry Christmas to Sean and to Vaz. It's a tricky game.
Yeah, now make sure you don't miss this over the Christmas holidays.
Second star to the left.
A tale of Christmas hope.
We can make a little girl very happy.
Or Christmas courage.
Speak, sir, or by thunder I'll run you through with this very sharp twig.
And Christmas presents.
Happy Christmas, Polly.
Second star to the left. Christmas morning at 9:30 on CBBC1.
Ho, ho, ho. Dominic Wood is our special guest coming up a little bit later on this morning.
But right now on CBBC, it's time for Smart.
Body beautiful, believe it or not. What are you two up to, please?
We're exercising.
Right, yes. We're trying to get into shape.
Speak for yourself, mate. I'm at the peak of physical fitness. I just need a little toning, and then I'll be the perfect example of a homo sapien. In other words, a faultless man.
Yeah, Mark, I think you two've got a long way to go before you're that. I'm going to go and do some art.
Ooh. Now, Mark, what's she on about? You know, I need to gain a little bit here and maybe lose a little bit here.
I don't know, those two, they do make me laugh. As if I'm going to be impressed with all that bodybuilding stuff. You are the shape you are, and that's it. But here is a way of getting your artwork in shape. It's a 3D picture in a box, and the first thing you need to make it is a box. I've got a cereal box here, and you need to measure out a rectangle and cut it out, because that's going to be the size of your picture. And then you need to fill in the edges, just to make this box solid, with some strips of cardboard. Here, I've sellotaped them together, and you can see they're the same thickness as the box, so that when I pop that in there, it becomes a nice solid, which is ready to be decorated. You could paint it, or you could use sticky back plastic, which is what I've done, in this nice wood effect here, which you can get in craft shops, and this is now ready to have a picture added to it. So you already know what size you're working to, because you've cut a rectangle out, and I'm going to be using coloured card. But if you haven't got coloured card, don't panic, because you could just paint your your card different colours. And the first thing I've done is my fruit bowl shape here, which is very boring at the moment, so I'm going to put a bit of a pattern onto it. And I'm using some grey diamond shapes that I've cut out, which are kind of adding a bit of shading to it, because when I add smaller little diamond shapes here that you can see, that starts to look a little bit like cut glass on there. And once you're happy with where you've positioned everything, you can stick that all down and it'll look like this one here, which is now ready to have loads of fruit added to it. So the fruit, first of all, I'm going to make some oranges, which are made with one circle of orange first of all, quite a nice orange size, but then add to that a slightly smaller circle and in a slightly different shade as well, and glue that bit there and add an even smaller circle of orange, again changing the colour so that you get this nice effect here, a 3D build-up, and that is ready to go. I'm going to have two oranges, and the next thing I need are some cherries, which are made with a little brown stalk like this, and then the cherries are kind of a heart shape at the top. And they look a little bit like mini apples, which if you just stick those onto your stalk, are ready to go, ready to pop into the fruit bowl. I'll have a few of those, I think, cherries. Next up, we need the grapes. Now, these are really easy. Loads of green circles, which you just add onto each other to start forming a little bunch of grapes like that. You can glue those all down. You can see starting to look like a bunch of grapes, and the only other thing to add again is a nice brown stalk, and once that's all glued down it'll look like this one here. Brilliant bunch of grapes there, all ready to go. And I think I need some bananas, so they're really easy as well, just nice big yellow banana shapes. And the only other thing I've added is some brown bits, which just kind of define them a little bit more. So I've got all my fruit, it's time to assemble everything now. And the brilliant thing is you can decide whether you want things inside or outside your fruit bowl. So I think the oranges would be sitting sort of inside, this one quite the way down, that one a little bit further up. And the cherries as well would perhaps be slightly hanging over, and some of them inside the fruit bowl there, like that. Now the bananas are very, very big, so they'd probably be hanging over the edge like that. But remember, don't go outside your rectangle frame, otherwise it's not going to fit into the box. And finally, the grapes would go over that side. And then it's just a question of sticking it all down and adding it into your box. So let's get the box back. Let's add this in, just slide it in that side, push it nice and neatly in, and there you have it.
Oh, very nice.
Oh, thanks. It's a relief, a sort of 3D.
A sort of 3D? Well, this is an actual 3D.
Adam Didlick wants to know, how do you draw a jellyfish? Now, the most common in the world jellyfish has a body shape which is kind of like a bell. Now, I'm just going to just add a nice kind of heavy line to the side of that and draw some swirls inside. And that's its sort of intestines. And then from there, there's going to be little kind of coiled tentacles that just kind of start spring-loaded like that. And then they kind of straighten out as they go further down. See? Move around in the current of the water. Now, to make it look a bit more three-dimensional, I'm going to add another pen, a slightly different colour, and add to that body. Now, because they're translucent, we're only going to draw a little bit of colour like that. There's some more in the intestines. And again, some more colour and those lovely long tentacles. But watch out, because most of them pack a sting. You don't want to get them on you. So there's your answer.
Time now to feature your work in our gallery.
I think Sophia's picture of a sleeping bishop is absolutely outstanding.
You get a great sense of impact from this snake's head painted by Charlie Thomas.
Seven-year-old Hussein has shown just how easy it is to make a really effective picture just by ripping up strips of coloured paper.
If you'd like us to frame your work, then look out for the address at the end of the show.
Trace wants to know, how do you draw a star? Well, there are a few ways of doing this. First of all, start by drawing a triangle like that, and then just do an upside down triangle over the top of it. Or how's about starting with an arrow shape like that, and then bringing your upside down triangle back again like that, but this time meeting at those points in the middle there. Let me show you again. Start with a bit of an arrow shape. It's a bit like a Star Trek badge, isn't it? And then an upside down triangle meeting there, like that. Or, if you get really clever, what about this for not taking your pencil off the page? Another star for you. Why don't you give it a go?
Singing in the rain, what a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds. The sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love. Let the storm.
Don't you just wish you could somehow magically brighten up this horrible, gloomy English weather?
Come on with the rain, I've a smile on my face.
You see, even the most picturesque landscapes can look dull and boring without a dash of colour. This is the famous Glastonbury Tor in the heart of Somerset, home to many myths and legends. Now, according to my ye olde book, it says here this place is closely linked to King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table, and is supposed to be where the Holy Grail is buried. There's even meant to be fairies here. Now, I don't know about fairies, but I'm going to add a bit of my own magic to this place and add a dash of colour.
Now, for my picture, I'm going to be using this permanent pen to work out where everything is. There's the hill. Of course, those amazing lines that cut through it go in there, and that line goes there. If you do make a big major mistake like this, you can always do this, which is a little key to tell you this is a wrong line. Don't copy it later. Fantastic. Now, that picture is kind of finished, looks a little bit rough, but we'll be using it later because I'm going to be doing my next stage onto this. It's clear acetate film. Now, if you haven't got it, you can always use tracing paper. And I've got here some oil pastels. Now, what I'm going to do is build up a whole layer of colour onto this acetate sheet, as many colours as I can possibly get into it. Turn this bit of a dull, drab day into a nice, colourful, wacky, wild day. Now, of course, none of these colours actually exist in reality. It's all a little bit of imagination we're using here. Doesn't it look good? It's all waxy on this side and lovely and glossy on this side. So what I'm going to do with this is add it to the picture I did earlier. So let's put that underneath there and redraw over the top of my picture with my lovely pen. If I went down this line again, pushing nice and hard, look what happens, not underneath that layer, but underneath this layer. Look, you can see a multicoloured line up here. And that's basically what my picture is going to be, a multicoloured line drawing. Now, because all that needs to happen is some pressure onto this, if I draw with this what is effectively a leadless pencil, it will still make a really good mark underneath.
The wonderful thing about this is it's a complete mystery. I have no idea what sort of mark I'm making. In fact, I'm getting very curious to see what exactly is going underneath here. Should I have a little peek? Hey, pretty good so far. See, this is the perfect way to turn a dull day into a colourful picture. Here's another technique you can do. Try using your thumb. Why? Because remember, this picture is about how much pressure you put on the paper. And so if I press really hard with my thumb, I should get, what looks like some sort of cloud. Now, the trick is not to do too much because the line is really important and the way it wonderfully changes colour is absolutely magical. So really, you just want to keep it as simple as that. Now, what I have to do is put this in a frame and it will look amazing.
How do you draw a fire engine?
Right, Anna, it's a very quick way. Start off with a square and put a roof on it, like a house. Here we go. There's the roof. Now turn it to the side. And then, if you start using this square here, the windscreen, cut little headlights. Can you see what it's transforming into now? That becomes the windscreen here. We've got the wheels. This, of course, is a very quick. And then there's for your ladders. Here's a little siren. And there you have, look. An instant fire engine.
What do you think of that?
That's great.
This studio might look big, but by the time we get all the cameras, lights set, not to mention people in here, there's barely a spare corner for me to show you my pocket money makes, which this time are these brilliant undersea pictures made, believe it or not, just from food colouring and salt. The first thing you need to do is draw out your design on a piece of cartridge paper and then stick it onto a piece of cardboard so that when it gets wet, it doesn't all bobble up, and then just start to paint your design with the food colouring, which you can just get very cheaply in supermarkets. And make sure you get your picture quite wet, because once you have completed your design, it is time to add the salt, which is just ordinary table salt. Now give it a really good liberal sprinkling all over your picture, really pour that on. And once you've covered it, just leave it to dry. And once it has dried, you can start to tap off the salt. Now the brilliant thing is some of the salt actually stays on your picture, which gives it a really nice textured effect, and sometimes just slightly changes the colour as well, so that when it's all tapped off it looks something like this. And the final thing I've done is just outlined around the edges to give everything a little bit more definition. Why don't you give it a go?
French artist Henri Rousseau came to painting late in life. He was in his 40s when he started to paint seriously, and he was totally self-taught. Perhaps because of this, his art was initially considered naive and simple, and was often ridiculed. But he never lost faith in his own ability, and his work was eventually celebrated by many famous artists, most notably Picasso.
They particularly liked his quirky, dreamlike attempts to represent modern trends, such as this relatively new game of rugby.
Although why they're wearing pyjamas has never been fully explained. Over here, son.
Hoi! Hey! Hot! Oh, fantastic. Yes, I can't see why Kirsten was laughing at Jay and I. We're real he-men. But I'm going to draw a really strong male. I'm going to start by using white chalk on black card. Now, I'm just going to use this pencil to give me a bit of detail. What I'm going to do here is not draw the picture itself, but rather the light that reflects onto it. And I want you to fill in the gaps. OK. Let's sketch him out first.
Lovely. Now I'm using a softer chalk just to give it a bit of texture. Just watch this now. If I drag it along the lines I've just already drawn, that's the shoulder here and the arm, stomach, and just bring my finger down from that edge. You see it gives a lovely fur texture. Look at that, all the way up his arm. Isn't that wonderful? Do a bit more on his shoulder here. And again, for this arm. Oh yeah, that's excellent. Strengthen the top there. That's perfect. Now, what I want to do now is just suggest the curvature of this little chap's stomach. So, I do a couple of lines there and just bring that down. Curve that again. See his little tummy beginning to emerge. Now the trick is with these, with chalk drawings anyway, less is most definitely more, so you don't want to put too much on there. But what I do want to do is just add a bit more white to the top of his head and the muzzle. Oh, lovely. Very important artistic tool, the cotton bud, just to get in all those nooks and crannies. There. Wonderful. In fact, he looks almost human, doesn't he? And just to finish it off, I'll add a frame. Perfect. And there you are, a real ape. Oh!
Mark, you're not still going on about how fit you are you?
What? Oh, no, it was him. Honest.
I'm not overdoing it, am I, Mark? You know, all that.
I think you're great.
Burridge, you look ridiculous. How did you get such big muscles? They're not even real muscles, Jay. They're totally false. I don't believe you. Ooh.
Come.
Right, Speight, let's do this proper. Keep them mince pies' eyes peeled. Right, J-boy, I want the silk and lace case. I'm having a good old butcher's. Right, is the jam and toast quite clear? Nah, but I'm going to go for it anyway. Right, on the next episode of Smart, you will need... fine sandpaper. Here, where's my jam and toast then?
Jam and toast? Oh, that ain't proper cockney.
Oh, kill framboys. Come on, remember, he who draws wins. 81, 82,
oh.
83.
Oh, come on, Lance, I'm 83. Sorry I laughed at you.
83.
I don't think you 82. Need big muscles to be heroes.
84.
Come on, Kirsten, you 84. Can get to 100.
84.
You're both heroes 80. In my eyes.
Okay, you can stop.
Oh, but hang on, does this mean I can't get involved in the big picture?
Say sorry.
Sorry.
Okay.
Right. Okay. I'm over here.
We'll be right back.
fantastic.
It is brilliant.
Amazing. Great foliage. Well, I think that's enough art for one day.
Oh, yes.
And enough exercise.
So, until next time.
Bye. Bye. Do you get really impressed?
You can post your gallery pictures to Smart, PO Box 5053, London W12 6AW. And if you need a fact sheet, then send a stamped addressed envelope to the same address.
As I'm rewinding that, I can show you my animal heads. They're so easy to make. Get yourself nice ping pong ball, some modelling clay. Here's two even balls. I can squash those onto the front like that. Get yourself another small ball. Put that underneath. And then another one. This is a different colour on top. And I'm going to squidge that into a nose-like shape. Whilst I get a pencil and put in nostrils. And while I'm there, some little dots on that. Now, with a very small bit of red, I can put in a tongue. And bring out the good old googly eyes. Stick them on there. And then all this dog needs is a lovely pair of ears. Look at that. Cute and cuddly. Cats and dogs. So easy to make. Go on, give it a go.
Stick around because the Wild Filmers are coming up in a few seconds' time.
Our special guest this morning is Dominic Wood.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Good morning. It's so lovely to see you this early in the morning.
Wake up. He's going to do a trigger thing, isn't he?
I am, yes. It does take long. It doesn't take long at all.
Okay, so how long is it going to take exactly?
Well, how long is a piece of string?
Well, no, how long is a piece of rope? Well, I've got two little pieces of rope right here. Watch. Here goes. One, two, three, go. Done.
Wow. But that is, all that is good.
Isn't that amazing?
That's really good. The card's going to come out your mouth.
No.
I don't believe it. Okay, now you're going to stick around, aren't you, to play our Santa's Stack Attack game?
Like a leech on someone's leg. Yes.
That's a nice
stick around.
You're going to be the Christmas tree or you're going to be the snowman?
I'll be the Christmas man. Snow tree. I don't know.
Thank you, Dominic. Stick around for Santa's Stack Attack coming up after the Wild Thornberrys.